Hi, in this video I'm going to show you how to create an election poster in Photoshop. I made a similar video, but then I used Adobe Illustrator. In case you missed that, please check links in the description so that you can go and watch that. So my friend, the first thing you need to have is the picture of that very person who is, you know, competing in the elections. So my friend, I downloaded these very images from Google, and I want just to make this very clear that this video is not sponsored by any political party, neither is it affiliated to any political party. Every image and logo used in this very video is just for teaching purposes. It is not affiliated to any political party. I just needed to make that clear before we continue with this tutorial. So my friend, I have three images. I just needed to show you what you can do to make your photos pop. So allow me to open all these images inside Photoshop, and then I will show you what I did, and you can go and do it on your images. So my friend, this is the image I downloaded from internet. Then the first thing I did was to remove the background. I used a pen tool to remove the background, and this is what I had. So this is the image without the background. After that, I realized that this image was a bit dull, so I needed to add some adjustment layers. So my friend, to do that, you just click here and you can select between these very adjustment layers. So I used curves, then I used levels, I also used vibrance and exposure. So these are the four adjustment layers that I normally use to make my images pop. So after that, I got this after image. You can see it has a difference from the first image. It is at least beautiful, and you can see that it is quality. So my friend, I just needed to mention that you need to remove the background. After that, you need to also put some filters so that your image will look fine. I was so quick, so I might have made some mistakes, but then you can take the whole time in the world to make your image pop even more than this. So my friend, allow me to do away with these two images and remain with the one that I'm going to use in this very tutorial. So the first thing we need to do is to create a new file, and to do that, you just click on file and click on new. Then this new document dialog box will load, and all we need to do is to rename our very file. So we can call it William for President, just like that, maybe 2022, just like that. Then I want to use an international paper. I will choose A3. Then I will leave this to be the way they are, because I need to have a portrait poster. And then the resolution, I will have it at 300. The color, I can play between RGB and CMYK. So for print, you will use CMYK, but for posting, you will use RGB. So let me assume I'm going to post this online, so I will use RGB. And my friend, just click OK to create a new document. Now, the first thing we need to do is to throw in the picture, then we see how we are going to move from there. So what I'll do, I will come here, and then I will select my layer. I will come to edit and say copy. Then I will come here, come to edit and say paste, just like that. The image will be paste, and all I need to do is to resize this. Ensure you hold Alt and Shift to make sure that the image is well scaled, and then I will just click here. So the image is in here, we are now set. So we can rename this to our image or subject. So let me call it subject, just like that, so that we are organized. So we have our image, and then the next thing we need to do now is to draw the shapes that you saw before. So my friend, I will now come to here, and I will pick the rectangular tool, the regular rectangular tool, and then I will just draw a rectangle here, just like that. And then I will give it a different color, come to RGB and give it red, just like that. Then I will collapse that. I will take the move tool and place it here. First of all, I can just hit Ctrl T to access the transform tool. I can now transform this just like that, and I will resize this just like that and place it just like that. yes, that is fine. And then I will say, okay, I can push it further, just like that. So I'm finished with that corner. The next thing I want to do also, I want to create other rectangles, then place them wherever I feel they should be. First of all, I can put this off because we do not need it at the moment. So I'll create the next rectangle, just pick the regular rectangle, and then I will just create a square. So to create a square, you hold shift and then you drag. So that will create a square. I will change its color to blue. We shall change these colors some other time. So I'm just giving it random colors. Then from there, we can give it different colors. So I will have that as that. I can also resize this just like that. Then I will make a copy of this very rectangle and I will change its color to something else, just like that. And I will bring it back here and make sure that it snaps just like that. I will also hit Ctrl T and make it a bit bigger than the other one, just like that. I will click here and I will drag this and place it behind that. So I'll have something like this. I hope it is well placed. If you doubt that, just select the two and come here, make sure that it is well centered. And I will make this a bit bigger so that this margin grows thinner, just like that's fine. Hit enter to accept that. And my friend, all I need to do is to take these two, hit Ctrl T, and I will rotate just like that so that it forms something like this. I think at an angle of negative 45 is fine, so I'll just type in negative 45. Just like that, and I will accept the changes and place it over there. I hope you are seeing where we are moving to, and this will be fine, right? I hope you are getting value, and in case you are getting value in this video, please boop that like button for algorithm purposes. The next rectangle I want to make is the same rectangle. So all I need to do is just to draw a rectangle. I'll leave it to black because I'll change it later on. So I'll do that, and I will also resize this just like that. I don't need to hold even shift, I just need to resize it, and I will hit Ctrl T and rotate this just like that, and I will bring it to this end. Let me zoom out just like that, and I will make it a bit bigger so that it covers this very place. In the meantime, I feel that this is fine. I will hit enter to accept that. I will also draw another rectangle. So we are going to draw so many rectangles. Don't worry. I hope you are not bored. If you're bored, please forward this so that you know you skip this very part. But then you can stick around to see what we do. I'm sorry, I've added another rectangle which is not needed. So I'll just reposition this. First of all, I will increase this just like that, and I will Ctrl Z. I'll just rotate this just like that and bring it somewhere here, make it a little bit bigger, just like that. I'll also make it that way. Let me zoom out just like that, place it somewhere here. I think that's fine. We shall arrange this some other time. Then I will copy this and push it a little bit up. So all I need to do is to just hit Ctrl J, and after that I will push this just like that. And all I need to do is to change its color to a different color, just like, I think that's fine. Then I will reposition it just like that. I needed it to appear over there. I feel that's okay. That's fine. So I want this to be behind, so I'll select this and drag it below that so that it is behind that. Then I will take this and make it a little bit bigger so that it covers that, and I will reposition this just like that and accept that. You can see this is not fine, so all I need to do is to select the two rectangles and I will push them up just like that. So you need just to bring them to the top and maybe reposition them just like that. It's now time to get back our subject, so I'll just click there and make sure that he is seen. And my friend, I'll just at least make him bigger, just like that. I'll bring this in here. Allow me to make him this big or this small, I don't know. That's fine. Yes, that's okay. Let me see. We can still reposition him some other time, so don't worry about that. That's fine. I can take this and push it a little bit there. Yes, that is very, very fine. Then the next thing you need to do now is to bring in the logo. So all I need to do is to come to File, and I'll say Place Embedded. Then I will come and pick my file. So I'll come back to Downloads, then Election Poster. I'll pick the file and place it just like that. I will resize it. Sorry. I'm so sorry. I think this thing is misbehaving. Yeah, that's fine. If you feel it is too small, you can still make it a little bit bigger. Maybe if you want it to be seen, just like that. Yes, so I'll place it somewhere here, because I still feel like I need to write his name and all that, so it might take some space. So now time comes to now change the colors here and there. Now what will direct you to choose the colors is the logo. From the logo you will find the theme colors of that very party. So if you zoom in, we have green, black and yellow. So these are the main colors for this very team. So all you need to do now is to achieve the same colors in your very design. You may not want to use all of them, but at least involve the colors in your very design. So maybe this orange here, I can change it to yellow, because it's almost yellow. Change it to yellow. Then I will change this to green, so that we achieve that. And my friend, what I'm doing is that I double click on this very icon here. Then after double clicking, I'll have the color picker. If I go outside the color picker, it turns from this picker to an eyedropper. I don't know if you are seeing that. It will turn to an eyedropper. And all I need to do is just to click on that color. It copies that color and applies it to that very object or shape that you have chosen. So that is what I'm doing here. Don't think that I am doing magic. So all you need to do is to come out, click on the color. If I click here, it will change. If I click here, it will change. So what the eyedropper does is that it picks the color and it applies it on the very shape that you have selected. So I'll click on green and say okay. So we at least have the colors in here. And the next thing I want to do, I feel that this is too big, so I just want to resize it. I'll select both the rectangles and I'll just squeeze them just like that. That's fine. I can reposition them so that it covers this hand over here. Then hit enter. We shall reposition it if we need later on, but for now let it be there. Then I also feel you can also apply the colors that the subject is putting on. That's another criteria for changing the colors in here. But again, I want you to allow me to, you know, use some blue, because he's putting on navy blue and I feel like blue will match with this very outfit. So all I need to do is to select one of the rectangles, then I'll double click here, and again I'll come here and look for a good blue. Maybe that. I don't want to be that perfect, but I'll pick that. And then I will also apply the same color here and then change the opacity, right? So I'll double click here, then I'll come outside the color picker, pick this color just like that. Then I'll come to the opacity, and all I need to do is to reduce the opacity to something like 80-ish will be fine. If I feel it's still high, I can still reduce this to something like that. Look at that. That looks fine. Then this color here, I think I can give it a blue shade and maybe a dark one, or I can decide to give it a navy blue, right? Let me first of all click on it, double click here. Let me try. If I pick from this, look at that. That's fine. I feel this is okay. that's fine. I need something darker. Maybe that will work. I like that. Just like that. And then from there now, we need to start putting our text. I would leave this to be red, just like that. Or I can decide to change it later on. So I may change it or not change it. But what I need to do is to push it to something like that. Then you see over here, the photo is not looking fine. So we can apply a trick here. All we need to do is to select our subject, and then we can make a mask out of that. So I'll click here to create a mask. All you need to do is to click on this icon. It will create a mask. Then select the mask and then come and pick the brush, right? After you've picked the brush, you can increase the size of the brush. And all you need to do is to make sure that black is in the foreground. If you don't have this as black and white, all you need to do is to hit D on your keyboard. It will reset that, and you click on this small icon here to bring black in the foreground. So what black does in masking is that black will hide and white will reveal. So we need to hide some things here so that they are not seen. So all we need to do, once we have selected our very mask here, we need just to brush over this, just like that. So it will go and fade away, just like that. That's fine. We can rectify the other things later on. If you feel that it is too much, you can now change to white and maybe reduce the size and try to bring back some of the things that you've lost here. So that's what white does, just like that. I feel that's fine. If we need to change, we shall change it some other time. So we need to write our text, and maybe from there we now will be coming to the end of this very, very tutorial. So you need to pick the text tool, and you will pick the horizontal text tool, and then you write your text in here. And then from there, we shall just be, you know, changing the colors and the fonts here and there. So first of all, I want to write his name. So I'll just write, should I write doctor? No, just allow me to write the name without doctor. So I'll just write William. Then I will hit Control A to select everything. I will increase the size just like that. And then I will change the color to black at the moment, just like that. Then the type of font I want to use here is called Poppins. So Poppins is a free font that you can get online. So you can always visit DaFont and you will get this font for free. So all I need to do is to hit on this black, Poppins black, just like that. I think I like that. Then alignment, I will pick to be aligned to the left, just like that. I will pick the move tool and just move it here. Then I will copy this very text. All I need to do is to select the text. Then I will hold Alt and drag, just like that. Then I'll double click here to write the second name, just like that. Then I want to just hit Control T, and I will resize this very, very text. I want it to fit there. I'll zoom just like that and place it there. Let me zoom just like that. Feel that's okay. I'll hit that. So we have William Ruto. Now, let me select the two and just make them a little bit smaller, just like that. Then I will place them there. In the meantime, let that be there. Then I want to write for the position that he is vying for. So first of all, I'll create a rectangle so that I can write on top of it. So I'll just draw here a rectangle, just like that. Then I will change the color to something bluish at the moment. And then what I need to do is to write the position. So I'll just click in here, and then I will reduce this very size and write for president, just like that. Then the font I want to use for president is called Acrobat. So I'll come here and just type in Acrobat Black and choose that as my font. and I can, you know, increase the size a little bit, just like that. I will drag this and put it on top of this very, very rectangle. Then I want to make sure that it is centrally aligned as well as vertically aligned. So what I need to do is to select the two, that is the for president layer and the rectangle. Then I'll come and click here for vertical alignment. I will also click here for horizontal alignment. Then I want to push them a little bit up. So all I need to do is to zoom in and push it up just like that. Voila, that is fine. Then on this rectangle, I want to do something a little bit so that it looks nicer. So I can now decide to apply a gradient. So a gradient is a mixture of more than two colors. So I don't want it to be just a solid color. So I'll double click on the right hand side of this very layer to access the blend if options, and I'll just push this here. Then all I need to select is the gradient overlay. Make sure it is checked. And then in here, I'll just click here to access this. Then I will come and pick this very color. This is to the shadows and this is to the highlights. So I'll pick the shadows and then click in here and maybe use something like blue. So we may decide to use this blue just like that and say, okay. Then I will click on the highlights. I'll click here. Then we shall use this red so that it is well mixed, just like that. After that has been done, I'll hit OK. Then all you need to do now is to change this very angle. Just change it so that it suits your very desire. Maybe something like that is fine. You may want to add some other colors. Maybe you can add in black, you can add in some white or 50% black. That is very fine. You can also change the scale. You can have it at 100 or you can have it lesser than that. So maybe I'll push it a little bit more than 100 to fade in very, very good to something like 150. That is fine. Then you can decide to change the style from linear to radial if you want to. But for this, I just need it to be linear. Then we can push a little bit just like that. You can change the angle to your liking until you feel like this is fine. So for this tutorial, allow me to leave it at that point and just hit OK. So we have our rectangle with its effects. You can always put them off if you don't want them. You can also put them on if you want to use them. So I'll just hide them just like that. I'll come to my text and now change the color of the text to white. Now look at that. I think I like that. We are moving somewhere. Now, the next thing I want to do now is to write, when does he want to be the president, right? So all I need to do is now to come and write in here. Remember, we have text here. So all I need to do is to just hit T on the keyboard to access the text tool. I'll click here to have the dummy text. I'll increase the size a little bit. Then I will say, maybe when are the elections? Maybe August. So we can just write August in short. And then maybe 2021, just like that. Maybe if you know the exact date, you will write there the exact date. For me, I don't know. And my friend, that will be fine for you. So I'll hit Control A to select all. I'll hit the character and I will increase this very tab so that we have this. My friend, you've realized that we've made a mistake. It is 2022. I'm sorry. It's not 2021, 2022. Just like that. The alignment, I'll leave it to be to the left because I like how it appears. So I'll push this in here. I will hit Control T and then I will just resize this just like that. Now look at that. I think I like this. I really, really love this. Then here I can decide to use either Acrobat Black or Acrobat Bold. So I think this is Acrobat Black. I may leave it at that point, but I can change to bold to see the difference. Bold is a little bit thinner. I don't like that. So I'll leave it at black so that it is fine. Thank you. You can decide to play around with the colors. Maybe you can play around and give this something like yellow. We are trying to achieve the colors of the logo. So I'll just pick this very yellow. Now look at that. I think I like that very yellow or in there. It looks fine. I may decide to change this to black. Will it really work? Green and black? I don't know. Let's try and put black in here just like that. Let me see. I think I also like that. But then if you feel like it's off, you can really do away with the black and just leave it to be white. But for me, let me leave it at black. I think I like that. Then the next thing you need to do, you can now write what we call manifesto. So my friend, maybe he has something for the people. So tell people, what does he have for them? So you can write it over here. But then I feel like there's something off here, especially with this rectangle. So I want to push it a little bit down so that it is below this very our rectangle. So all I need to do is to click and drag it down. Now look at that. I think I like that. It now looks at least professional, my friend. That is very fine. So I said you can write the manifesto. Maybe for me, I wrote something like for the people, and maybe write something that he's going to do for the people. So what I'll do, I'll hit T to access the text tool. I'll click to have the dummy. Then I write for the, just like that. Then for this font, I'm going to use a font called Bookmark Old Style. So I'll just write here, book. Then I'll have bookmark old style. So you can have regular, you can have bold, whichever you like, right? So I'm going to pick this. I think I love that. Then I'll hit V to access my move tool. I'll place it here. I will make a copy of this because I still need the same font and write people just like that. I will hit this to accept. Then I'll hit Control T and resize this to somewhere like, I think that's fine. I can reposition this to, that's fine. I can reduce this a little bit, just like that. That's fine. I can select the two people and for them. Then I will push them a little bit down, just like that. I can change their color at once to something like white. I think white will do me fine. Then after you've written that, you will now want to write what he has for the people. You will write the manifesto, what he's doing for the people, and why they should be voting for him. So all you need to do also is just to pick the text tool and write your information here. For this very video, I don't have information. So all I need to do is to copy this and just paste it severally so that it makes something like a paragraph. I'll hit Control A, then I'll reduce the size, just like that. Then I'll come in here, then I'll change this font to something like, I don't know if I have a Brima, let me try if I have a Brima. A Brima will do fine. Yeah, I can use the regular one. I think this is fine. What I need to do is to make it a little bit, you know, lengthy. So maybe I can just place this here. My friend, I don't have things to write here. So I'll copy this with Remy Psalm. Copy, Control C to copy. Paste, enter, then paste. I don't have information. So my friend, just allow me to do this for today. Next time I will have something to write. It's only that I don't have his manifesto. And by the way, if there is someone who needs to have his posters designed, you can always contact me and I will be very much willing to always work with you, because this is what I do and I love doing this. So I'll hit Control A to select everything, come here and bring this closer, just like that. Then I'll come here and I'll hit enter at this very point. Just trying to make it look nicer and beautiful. Just like that. I'll come here, sorry. Select this. Just like that. If you feel you need to fill this place, you can always now take this and maybe copy the whole of this. Control C, come here and just hit enter, Control V to have that. And maybe I will take this in here, take this down here, just making it look nicer. Remember that. so that it is well represented. I don't want to have something that looks awkward, just like that. Hit here to accept that. So that is fine for the people. This is what is going to be doing for the people. And if you feel it is too small, you can hit Ctrl T and resize. You can resize it to something like that. I think that's fine. Then you accept the changes. So that is what is going to be doing for the people. Then after that, we can have a slogan down here. So I also used a gradient on this, so I don't want to waste time drawing another rectangle. All I need to do is to just copy this rectangle. Remember, we made it before. So I'll just click and drag in here. I told you, just you hold Alt and then you drag to make the changes. It's moving in both directions, so I'll hit Ctrl Z. I will delink this so that it's just moving in one direction, just like that. And push this a little bit down, then make room for the text and push it in here. I think I move the arrows just like that, and I can make sure that it is at the center. So I'll select the background and make sure that it is vertically aligned. Now that is fine. You realize that the blue here is not visible because it is the same blue here. So I'll just select this. Remember, we had the effects. Then I'll just double click on the gradient to go and edit this very blue. So I'll click here once, then come here and choose something, maybe dark. Yes, something dark. I just need it to be visible, just like that. You will take the whole time in the world to rectify that and make it look beautiful. Then all I need to do is now to write the very, very slogan. I'll hit T and then write this. So let me first of all increase this just like that and write. I wrote there, your vote can make a change today. Just like that. Then I put exclamation mark, Ctrl A to select everything. Then I will reduce this to that very thing size, and then I'll take the move tool, I'll position this here, and I'll zoom in and hit Ctrl T and try to make it bigger. Ctrl Z. Let me resize this well, holding Alt and Shift. I feel that's fine. Then I'll hit OK. I can decide to use, let me see if Nexa will work here. So let me just come here and type in Nexa. Then I'll take bold. Yeah, I feel that's fine. Then I'll select this very layer and make sure that I've also selected this rectangle. And then I'll make sure that it is vertically and horizontally aligned, just like that. Now look at that. That looks fine for me. The next thing I want to do now is to write here, vote for maybe something. What should we write? Vote for change, something like that. I don't have much to write there, so let me copy this and bring it here. Then I write vote, just like that. And I would want to use red, so it's conspicuous and speaks much of volume, just like that. And I'll position this in here. Then I will write something down here, vote for change. Or you can now use the Hustler Nation, because DP uses Hustler Nation as his very slogan. You may want to use there, maybe vote for Hustler Nation. Let me write there, Hustler Nation. Sometimes you need to read it that way so that you get the right spelling. I'll make sure that it is well positioned. Let me push this here. Then I will change the color to white. I think white will do fine. Yes, look at that. I think I like that. So vote for Hustler Nation. I think this is going to go far. I hope that this is going to reach far. And my friend, in case you are finding value in this very video, you know what to do. Hit that like button for algorithm purposes. So I'll select this and resize it. I want it to be bigger and visible, just like that, and place this here. I'm not trying to be dramatic, just making a YouTube tutorial. Now, the next thing I want to do, maybe you can include your contact, or you can include your website where people can locate you if that is necessary. So you may want just to type something down here. So let me copy this just like that. And you can say visit, maybe you can write for more info, visit, let me have comma, then visit, then you'll put your URL. Let me use mine, aeroproductions.co.kb. Then you can always resize this and check that. Then for this, I want to use Nexa Lite. So I'll just type in Nexa and I choose Lite. And I will also make sure that it is centered. So I'll just select that and then I'll come to the background and make sure that this is centered just like that. Now look at that. That looks professional. Now the next thing is to find where to put this very logo. You'll put it at a place you feel like it is well seen and a place you feel like it is fine. Then I also feel this is too big, so let me go back to that rectangle. Where was it? Let me just hit on it. Yes, there are these. Then the August text, let me look for August. I think it's this one. Then all I need to do is to hit Ctrl T and resize them and reposition them in here. I think this is now fine. It's too big. Yes, looks fine from far. That's fine. So all I need to do now is to just add in a little bit of little edits. So what I'll do, I'll take this logo and put it in the background, right? So I'll copy this logo just like that. I will hit Ctrl T and I will resize this, make it bigger. Bigger and even more bigger. Just like that, I'll push it here. Then I'll hit this tick. Look at that, that looks fine. Then all I need to do now is to just push it in the background. You can just do this and push it in the background. Now it's in the background. All I need to do is now either to reduce its opacity or to blur it. So my friend, I'll choose to blur it. All I need to do now is to come to filter, then blur, then Gaussian blur. I'll push this in here, then I will increase the blur until I feel it's fine. That looks fine for me. Maybe I can do 20-ish, just like that. Then I can reduce its opacity. I don't want it to be so conspicuous. So I reduce its opacity, just like that. Let me see this smart filter, if I turn it off and reduce the opacity. Now it looks faded, so I'll Ctrl Z, then I'll turn this back on. Yes, that now looks fine. I can now reduce the opacity just like that. That one looks fine. Maybe it just needs a little bit of repositioning to somewhere like there. I think that's fine. I can also just accept and make sure that you do that. Hit enter to accept the changes. And maybe reposition it just like that. The Hustler Nation. Then I feel like changing the color of this very name. So I'll choose this to be green. So I'll come here and pick this green. And I'll say okay. Maybe I just need to increase the saturation. Let me see how it will look like. It takes time to update. Let me hit okay to see that. Nope, that's not fine. I think I need a dark one. Yeah, that looks fine. Then William, for William, I'm going to use yellow. So I'll come here and just hit here to pick the yellow, push this to the corner. Yellow, will it really work? Let me have some different shade of this. I don't think if that would work for me. So I may not want to use that. So I can decide to use this navy blue. Let me see how it picks. Yeah, that looks fine. That looks fine. Yeah, I think I like that. I can leave it at that moment. This is now, you know, personal. It is subjective. You can change this to your liking. You can position this, just get there. You can change this to your liking because it's now subjective. My friend, I feel like the poster is complete. You can make other changes if you want to, but this is fine. And I believe that if someone sees this very poster, he will be happy to, you know, go and vote, and maybe he will be happy to just check it because it looks conspicuous, it looks fine, and it is professional. My friend, if you are designing professional posters, it is better to use professional fonts. Don't use stylistic fonts in professional work unless the client asks you to do so, right? So you do according to what the client wants you to do. Otherwise, I hope that this video has helped you. And if that is the case, feel very, very free to boop that like button. And you can also subscribe to this YouTube channel, and not only subscribe, my friend, ring that bell so that you do not miss any other future tips, tricks, or tutorials. Otherwise, I hope I will see you in my next video. Peace.